used to be my landlord some times back. I'm still buying time. And this gentleman, at that time, he was 70. That was 2005. You can calculate how old he is now. He's a businessman like Francis. And I spoke to him and I sold this idea. I was talking about this idea of Brikenna to him. And he told me, Jane, you can never go wrong in property. So he said, I am still buying. So at least I've got hope. I can see a few people who are over 50. So I am trying to encourage somebody, don't give up. We can still go on. We'll still move on. Yeah. And I have known Tabitha and Francis for quite a number of years. And may I say that is why I'm in Brikenna. And when Francis stands here and talks about £10,000 paying to go and learn what he's giving you free, I am a witness. Francis is not jealous of sharing his what he has achieved or what he knows is going to be best for you. Because I am a witness of that, because I paid £5,000. They invited me, actually. I didn't know there is such seminars. They invited me. And I can see one or two people who are coming in the same seminar. I paid $5,000 to learn what you are learning today. What am I saying? Take full advantage. Because £5,000 sterling pounds is not cheap. And exactly the information he's offering you is exactly the same information we are being given, but at a fee. When Francis stands here and starts talking, don't think he's bragging. The last meeting we went to, was it Woolwich? London. I can see some of the ladies I'm going to talk about are here. I am not mentioning names. I am not going to point at anybody. But we went to the toilet, and I found some two ladies talking. And they were talking about Francis. Oh, and I said, oh, you know, I live in Luton, and I know his property. And they said, are you sure he's not bragging? I said, no, I am a witness. I know he's not. I'm talking this on behalf of those people who are here for the first time. It might sound like bragging. It might sound like pride. But guys, let me tell you, whatever he says, I am a witness. It is the plain truth. He's trying to help us. Now, going back to business, I went to view some properties in, actually that's one of the ones I viewed. I went to view some of the properties in Luton and I was amazed. And especially this day that we went, the two properties, there were some guests that had just left in the morning and there were others coming that evening, both properties. And when I was talking to Tabitha and Francis, they said, this is not the, I actually also checked them on their website just to make sure that is a business, is a viable business. But guess what? There is no one time I have found vacant rooms for more than 2 days. Always, they are always booked. So it's a good business. They are doing very well. And when we start investing, it is good to borrow. If you're doing it with Brikenna, they'll be there to help us. They'll be there to do the decor and the rest, because I think the houses are just beautiful, pretty, you know, good combination of colors, because that also counts. You know, they look after their customers or tenants, whatever you want to call them, well, and that is why they get bookings after bookings. So thank you very much, even for listening to me. Thank you very much for allowing me to see your properties, because there are not very many people who will allow you to go and see what they are doing, just in case you copy. And especially these people, I live in Luton, it is very easy for me to copy, but they are not afraid that they can have somebody competing with them. So thank you very much, and may God continue blessing you in whichever way you take. Thank you.
Put your hands together for mom. Thank you very, very much. Taking action. Now, I'm going to invite Francis to come. This particular property, if you go to booking.com, just type Tenninson House in Luton. This is one of the properties that we have. It is one that is rented out through booking.com, the hotels. And Francis will explain to us on that. But when I saw this property, when it was being, I was with Danny, the guy who left. I was with him. We saw this property when it was a dialect, as in it was really run down, and they did a lot of work on it. And the truth is that it is really, really, one of them has been booked for almost over a month, and somebody's paying almost £130 a day, you know? So there are different strategies that we want to show you, and I'm going to encourage you, please take some time. Somebody say, take some time. Take some time, we'll come and show you this thing so that you can come and see. So, Francis, are we good to go, or are we? Yeah, so I give you more minutes. So, yes, so Mr. Gakwo, why don't you just come and say one or two things here as Francis does what is that? Come, my friend, you know. Come, my friend. I know your time has not prophesy. Bonus for Zana. This is for you. Yeah.
Thank you very much. Good. It's nice to see you, all of you. I must say that I know Francis, and we've been together in some meetings. We met in that meeting our sister was talking about. Me and my wife, we joined in, and we had to go for 3 days holiday in a hotel where we are taught how to do business. There before we had made mistakes. I remember we bought our first property in 1999. It was actually in Luton. We stayed with that property for about 3 years. Then we sold it. That was the biggest mistake I've ever made in the property investment. We sold it, we made good money, and we thought this is the time now to invest in Kenya. So we made really good money because we bought it below 50, and we sold it above 500, above 100,000. So we made very good money, to be honest. So later on we went back to London. Fortunately that house gave us enough money to put down for the London property and also invest back home. Let alone we realized that we made a big mistake by selling our house in Luton, but it was never too late. So the investment that we had made in Kenya, we sold in 2008, came back and bought our first investment property in London in 2008. And we just kept quiet for quite some time. Then we realized that there's money in the property, especially my wife, she's very, very eager in this. When she heard about Matthew in Milton Keynes, she said, no, I'm not going to leave you, we have to go together. We went to the meetings and we are taught how to buy below market value. And we are able to explore the possibilities of getting properties through some brokers, through leveraging, you know, getting someone to do the resourcing for you, and then you pay them. And since then, things have never been the same. We've made quite a bit of progress in the property market, although not very good because we didn't have much information. But we thank God that at least now there's an opportunity for us to invest. One of the things that maybe Francis will tell us later is that nowadays it's very, very difficult for you to buy to let as a single person, because the government wants to encourage big companies, corporates, to buy houses, because they realize that individuals buying houses are not getting them what they want. So before, buy to let was determined by the rental income that the property is getting you. For example, if you're able to, if the rental income is above the mortgage payment, at least the companies or the banks will read you the money, because the comparables around you about 3 miles radius will give them approximately whether that property will be able to pay itself. Now, the government want that above the mortgage payment, there is some money somewhere that can be able to pay for the mortgage if the house is not rented out, and it was not there before. So they are encouraging people who have number of properties that can secure that mortgage if there is no tenant. So it's becoming difficult day by day. So this is the best vehicle now to invest in, because it's going to give you the dividends that you will get even if you have your own house. So I would encourage you to come on board, and also there is a chance for you as a single entity to go through Brikenna and get your own property. So thank you very much. I know time is going.
No, put your hands together for this man. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Now, I am going to really, really take this time to invite Francis to quickly tell us about some of the things that we are thinking about in project number two, and then thereafter, we'll then now give you an opportunity to be part of that. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Right. Okay. He showed you, well, let me brag. This income is from that property you just saw. This is income for this month. Next month, this is income. And that's only A, B, and B. We haven't even shown you the one I made when the return clients come and pay us cash. This A, B, and B. Sindio, we went through nikakwambia ufungue uafungulie mpaka pale tumefika earnings, and it's showing you, if you show, it's showing you 2,000 booking for 2,000, you can see, and enda chini kidogo tuangalie what's there. This is showing you the graphs. Look, these are the graphs of every Airbnb. Tujianza kizamani this particular property. This property was new the other day when it was the one which we were doing work on it. So it's just like we finished in December. But you can see the incomes we are making from that project. These are bookings for March. By the time it is March, we are expecting it to be there. April will be there. By December, it will be somewhere there. These are real figures, guys. Yeah? If I give you 7,000, really, ni joke. 1 house. Just 1 house. How much am I paying for that for the mortgage? Less than £500. This is serious money. I'm just showing you what I'm not just bragging. I'm not bragging at all. I'm just showing figures. You know, when you see, you'll see what I'm saying when I tell you. If your money is in the wrong place and it's not making money for you, that's what happens. But while I know that the money which we invest, how it makes money, solid money. So I just wanted to show you this one. And you're probably, hey, come on, that one is figuring it. Not here, my coffee, man. If you like it, man. So I'm just showing you figures as exactly, yeah. 20 something, yeah. Mm-hmm. So I'm introducing to a second strategy I use. So that's the second strategy we are using. Remember we talked about HMOs, multiple lets, where we are still making big figures, but it has a lot of work. But also this service accommodation. What's service accommodation? It's like a short stay. Holiday, professional builders, and all kind of stuff. When you know how to, because we have a team, we have the power, we have everything, we are able to do it more effectively, efficiently. Because this thing, inategemea vile mnaifanya. Some people say, I'm going to go and set it up. I tell them, yeah, do you have this resource? Because ukipata negative, even a small negative, they cut you off. That means that, because you get positive because their house is clean. It's like an hotel, it's like 5-star. You have to be there. You have to have people who know what they are doing. That's the reviews, what brings you more clients. If the review is bad, it's bad. And some people try this thing and they are very bad because they don't have time. If you're going to night shift, you don't have time to check your guests who are coming 11 o'clock. Did you? If you had the clients coming at 3 o'clock and the other one is leaving at 12 o'clock, what time will you have for cleaning and making sure the house is ready? How are you going to get the money? How do you get the things working? How do you furnish that property? How do you keep it on toes? Remember, this is somewhere that if anything, even the bulb or water or pipe burst, you have to have money to finance that very quickly. So you need the team, the system. Remember the system? And that's why we're saying, if we buy assets and we are doing that, we have the system. We have people who work for this. They have cleaners, everybody.
You understand? So we have all that team working, making us money. Because when you bring the money, we do all this stuff. Other people do the other job. And then the money is here. So if you're wondering where I'm going to pay your money, you're paying your money from, the dividends, you see, with that kind of figure, can I fail to pay you? You see? Because I'm not getting kidoga to nimepatia tu mtu mmoja. Atika tenant kamoja kanaletea kiki. If the tenant goes, I've got a void for 3 months. No, this thing is consistent. And the more we have more assets, the more we make. This is crazy money. I can assure that property will have made 150 by the end of the year. And let's have a look at it at the end of the year. I'll show you this chart next month, and we see how it is going. Then I'll show you again the next month we meet again. As demanded, I show you. We see how it's going. Sindio, so that you can see the growth of that particular property and many others which we're going to be putting. So even if we do your asset, we can be able to show you, look how your asset is doing. This is the asset we bought. This is how it's doing with this particular strategy. So you can see the money. And that's what we call transparency. No beating about the bush. Not cock and bull story. Not trying and testing. It's already tested. Now, this is what the government is doing. Guide to buy to let tax. This is sent by me straight away by my solicitor. Every time I buy a property, they are very happy to remind me the rules. Tax consideration for landlord investing in buy to let are changing in coming months and years. This is our guide to what you need to know. From 1st April of 2003, if you are purchasing a second property, you will need to pay an extra 3% stamp duty. Punishment. Pop. They punish you on top of what you pay for the other. This is a lot of money. So if you are buying a property of 150 or 200,000, that's nearly 7,000 pounds. Punish, you give the government. You need to have the resource. Also, whether you are buying a second home or an investment property, so it goes on. Let's go down a little bit, please. How to check when you are purchasing a property means you are liable for high rates. Here it is. This is what has changed. Before, how many properties do you own at the end of the day of the transaction? One, the transaction is not subject to the high rates regardless of what the property is used for. Two, is the property being purchased replacing your main residence? So all these are guidelines, all coming to one thing, the high rates, because you're going to be pushed to high rates. Because now, what the government is saying, previous main resident has not yet been sold. The transaction, even if you have a resident, let's say you had your own home and you buy another property and it becomes your own resident now. Before you do the second one, they still you have to pay the 3%. The other thing, remember the mortgage you used to pay, which is what we're going to go on? Nowadays, it's not going to be an expense. But remember, before it used to be an expense. If you are doing profit and loss, if you know what account says, it says, this is the money I've made from the tenant. Let's say I've made 3,000 pounds per year. But this is the mortgage I've paid, 1,500. So I've made 1,500, isn't it? Because you have subtracted the mortgage interest. But the government now, because you're an individual, is telling you, haha, that's a joke, that's gone. So let's go up a little bit. If I go there, let me come back. Little kidogo too. This is just calculating the 3% we were talking about. Kaleka vitu kangu nako hapo hivi. Sorry. So, the first 125,000, you pay nothing if that's your first property you buy. Zero. But if it's buy to let, second property, you pay 3%. Remember, this is the 3% they have added. For anything below 125, anything above 125 to 250, you pay 5% because they have, it was used to be 2%, which is here, but they added the 3% to make it 5. Anything which is between this and this, which is most of the majority of houses, will be around this figure here and or here. So this makes a very big difference because you don't gain. What is the 5% of 250, do you think it is? You can calculate it up quickly. Somebody? So, you will get your government by the end. In fact, that money should be with your solicitor by the time you're exchanging and completing. There's no buyers. You have to pay for it. And that's not part of the deposit. That's government money you have to give them. So when you are talking about deposit of 15%, we are forgetting to calculate these figures here. If this one even, we haven't added the solicitor's figure. We haven't even added the broker's figure and all that kind of stuff, valuation and all that stuff. So there's a lot of expenditures. So it depends where you are buying the houses. Look, eh? London, where we are talking about these figures here. It's crazy, you can know like that. But when we buy as a group, it's different again. The more blocks of flats we buy, we get government is even rewarding us. We pay nearly like 2%. If we buy a lot of, they say if you are buying a lot of them at once, you only pay for average. That's a joke.